question in our main event. What's he talking about? Here on Saturday night, already 20 at the sides. He feels he is going to be the man to become the next United States heavyweight champion. And, of course, in a week, Rain will have the brackets on that 16-man tournament.
Well, you know, a lot of people have a gripe about that U.S. title. Vader probably has the biggest gripe. The way he was stripped of it. For Stunning Steve never lost it either. He was jobbed out of it by Bockwinkel.
Steve Austin, the greatest.
Colonel Parker is back with him, apparently as his full-time manager. Let's go back to the ring.
His opponent from Venice Beach, California, weighing 251 pounds. This is
should be a classic one-on-one main event. And we'll have the match in its entirety here on WCW Saturday night. Right after this, I'm out. Stay with us, fans. All right, we are back. There's the bell. It's time for the main event. Before it gets well underway, I want to remind you the latest edition of WCW Magazine, Vader on the cover, will be available on newsstands everywhere this Monday. And, of course, the Brain still has his column, and
my mailman's become hunchback bringing my mail to me.
Not because you've been browbeating him so much? You tip him on Christmas? No, you don't. You can answer that.
For what? He gets paid by the USA.
All right.
I got to give the guy a handout because he can't get a better job. It's not my fault.
You're really a nice guy, Brain.
If he'd have gone to school, he'd have got a good education, become a senator, and learn how to take it off the top.
Aha. Skim. All right, Sting and Stunning Steve. In this one-on-one matchup, and certainly the man who wins this match has to be considered one of the top seeds for the tournament. Wouldn't you think so?
Well, I would think so, but there's going to be, what, 16 of the greatest superstars in WCW in the tournament?
It will, and next week we will have all 16. We will have the pairings and everything for you right here on WCW Saturday night.
You know, and if Hogan is still champion at that time, that's what everybody wants. You know, this is the biggest step to the World's Heavyweight Championship. Plus, you make a lot of money and a lot of prestige being a United States champion.
Speaking of Hogan, Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage are here. There's Steve with a great side headlock out of that head scissors. They are here, and we will talk to them about Nick Bockwinkel's statement earlier in this program where Bockwinkel said he will have a decision one way or the other next week. Now, you may be concerned, you Hulkamaniacs out there, that Vader is here. We have seen him go ballistic, as always. But we do understand there's a lot of security in the back.
I just got word from my man Woody. He says it looks like cops are back there. The TV show cops. He's never seen so many. So what they're trying to do is put up a wedge between Vader and Hogan.
So hopefully when Vader or when Hogan comes out later on in this telecast, he and Savage, Vader will stay in his dressing room.
Oh, that hallway will be full. It'll look like Hill Street Blues back there.
And, of course, tomorrow night, Big Bubba and Brad Armstrong. Okay, Stunning Steve and Sting now. Stunning Steve content with driving in the headlock here on Sting and trying to keep Sting grounded, Bray.
Certainly has.
Shoulder block takedown. Sting down low. Steve over the top. Sting with the gorilla press slam. Well, he hit hard that time.
Right on the spine, it looked like.
Steve slow to get up. Sting drop kicks him, and that one really didn't hit. Steve with a head of steam. Oh, my. And Sting takes him down. One. Sting, you may hear Sting telling Randy Anderson, watch the tights.
Seems to me like they're keeping each other grounded. They both want to keep it on the mat.
One, two. You can see very clearly that Steve had a handful of tights there once again.
Well, that was just to turn him over. Hey, if you don't want your tights grabbed, don't wear any.
Well, you can't do that.
See? That'll happen then.
You got to wear tights on. Never mind. Why am I discussing this with you? Go, Sting, go! Side headlock clamped on.
Wearing him down. I mean, Austin's the one that dropped to his knees.
Back up now. Into the corner. Sting is caught, and this is where he doesn't want to be, but this is pretty good maneuvering by Stunning Steve. The Colonel watching on. Randy Anderson calling for a break, and let's see if we get a clean one or not. Not. Well, we anticipated that one. He's hammering away on Sting now. Caught in the corner and a big chop to the chest.
Hold the rope. Hold the rope there. Good move.
Down goes Sting. Sting with a double leg pickup that time. He may be trying to... No, I thought maybe a Boston Crab. Throws him up. One, two. A two count.
Talk to the Colonel. Have a little conversation with the Colonel. Take your nine count. Get a breather. Let him make a mistake. Let him cool off. He's got the hot hand right now. That's what the Colonel's got to be telling.
Colonel trying to dust Steve off here and make him feel a little bit better, get back into this match.
There's the man you have to dust off, the Stinger.
Well, I would agree with that. Right hand by Stunning Steve. Sting picks him up, snaps him in, nicely done.
I would have gone for the cover there.
Now he's going to try and miss.
Going to get him a lot brighter.
And Sting?
Yes, you agree.
No,
thank you.
I don't agree. I would just try to clarify your statement there.
I'm brighter than you.
Well, you're the brain.
See? Gordon says he's smarter than you.
Gordon Solie?
Yes.
Well, he's been around a long time.
No, I mean, he said you were an idiot. But I don't want to start any trouble.
I don't. No, I'm not even talking. Double axe handle blow. By the way, speaking of Gordon Solie, of course, he and Dusty Rhodes and living legend Larry Zbyszko have the pro show, WCW Pro, each and every week.
They start everything off. They start a lot of troubles, what they do.
Also, they wanted me to remind our fans that they have been getting a lot of mail. And we have been getting a lot of phone calls here at the WCW offices, especially, and I want to clarify this one also, from creditors about Diamond Dallas. We don't know where he is. Leave us alone. Hopefully we'll never see him again.
Creditors?
Yeah, because apparently he has skipped town.
Bischoff
owes a lot of money.
Bischoff's been signing his name again and stuff. That had to be.
Bischoff just did an interview with him, that was all.
Not fair.
Counting on the back now. Stunning Steve continues the assault on Sting, and Sting is in trouble. One thing we know about Steve, he has so many different holds and maneuvers and ways to beat you, but he also has so many different ways to torture you.
He'll make you feel it in the morning that you've been in there with Stunning Steve, believe me.
Because he's always in great shape. He's a great athlete. And now he may be trying to Boston Crab here. And may have Sting over. One shoulder planted on the mat, turns him over,
got him.
And sets on it.
Ring the bell, ring the bell.
Wait a minute, you're not the referee.
He's not getting out of this. Ring the bell. You should sit a little further back on the lower part of the back.
A good look at Sting as Stunning Steve sets down hard on the back of Sting and pulls back. Oh, he's got the rope.
Well, that's to keep his balance.
Yeah, but that's illegal.
Yeah, but the ref didn't see it.
It doesn't matter.
Well, you should call.
They just did. Okay, there you go.
See? I'm just trying to tell the truth, and I'm for what's right.
Sting, draped over the ropes, dazed, in pain, winded here, shot hard into the middle, making the top turnbuckle in the neutral corner.
I hope Austin stays on that back. Now I'd give him a couple backbreakers right in the middle of the ring. Two solid backbreakers might bend him over that knee. Then I'd get the one-legged Boston Crab and just sit back with him. And bridge, probably. That didn't work. I'd get that big oak chair in the back, you know, with the high back.
Yeah.
Just part his hair with him.
Well, that's illegal also.
Yeah, you're right about that. You don't need Judge Ito here to figure out this one.
Sting defenseless in the corner. And Steve is champing away.
Austin's in great physical shape after coming back from that severe knee injury he had. Most people would take a lot of warm-up matches, but he wants Sting.
Very important, as we said, in determining a top seed in the U.S. title tournament. Sting in the corner!
Oh!
And again! All right, one more time! Steve ducked, though. And Sting will send him headfirst to the canvas. He's back into it, Brain.
He certainly is. Austin's got to slow down his momentum. He's got to get out of that ring and go to the Colonel. Or Colonel's got to do something. Once Sting gets his momentum rolling, he's very hard to stop.
And he's got it rolling right now. Here on WCW Saturday Night.
This is amazing. People can count to 10.
Landed on his feet, but Austin didn't with a clothesline.
Like he hit the back of his head also.
Sting sends Austin to the right side and has the sleeper hold on.
Austin's got to either get behind him or get to the ropes. He goes down. I didn't want to see that. That should be a bad sign. All depends how tight Sting has it around both sides of that neck. Well, he didn't have it hooked good enough. See, now this is illegal also. He didn't break the hold. Stinger.
To the side of the head, Austin plants a right hand. And Austin finds the ring post. Shoulder first. That's going to change the complexion of this one. First time someone has felt the steel in this match, and Sting's going to try to end it right now. He missed.
Get on him and cover him right now. Do what you have to. You got him.
Would you stop coaching, please? And cheerleading.
I just get excited. I'm sorry.
You are, must I remind you, and you say it so many times, a broadcast
journalist. Yes. Yeah.
So be one.
I know exactly what I am.
So do I.
Thank you.
Up on top. Steve missed. Now tell Sting to cover it.
Well, Sting can't hear me. He's half out.
Oh, okay. See there.
Sorry, fans.
Come on, Steve. Get up. Sting, get up. Get up! Come on, Steve. See, I'm being
chair
for each side.
You sure are.
Sting is up, but he is dazed. And I believe also some of that paint may have gotten in his eyes.
You paint your face, that can happen.
Yep, that's right. The sweat, and of course the contact rubs that paint off the face and maybe down in the eyes.
Drop.
Sting holds his balance. Steve holds his. Now it's Steve with... No, it's Sting. He got him. With the pile driver, and this could be it.
But he didn't get him that good, I don't think.
One, two...
No.
But he's on the rope. Uh-oh. Reaching for Steve's head enables Steve to drag him on the floor, and we've got a Donnybrook right below the apron. Steve smartly gets things going back in the ring. That's where you win it. Up and down. Sting rolls him up. One, two.
He got him. I want another camera shot of that. He had to hook the tank.
No, I did not.
He did, because I can tell from the way his leg was kicking. One wasn't and one was. It didn't look right to me.
Sting! No question about it. If WCW officials are looking, he has to be considered now one of the top seeds in the upcoming tournament for the U.S. heavyweight title.
And he could be out of it.